Welcome back to Obermott. Today we talk about new things at Obermott. We developed quite a few new features at Obermott, and I'd like to discuss them today together and hear your opinion about them.
Great. Very excited to hear what might be coming.
We went up with the coverage of stocks from 10,000 to 13,000 stocks.
Okay.
Then we introduced new selection criteria where you can now select for good governance companies, for instance. And that's especially valuable in emerging markets.
Yeah.
You want to have a good governance company. You can also select companies that are better with the climate change topic, with their carbon footprint.
So this, if I go into the filter, then I can search for companies that are particularly good when it comes to governance or the environment or, you know, the different factors that you've built in.
Yes, exactly. So it's basically things that, you know, you may want as a characteristic of your stock.
Okay.
You know, be good at climate, be good at governance, but also family friendly, you know, companies that allow mothers to stay home, look for the kids, work part time, allow fathers to work part time in management positions. So the family friendly companies is also a criteria that we have now. As an inclusion criteria, so that you know, you focus on stocks that are, have more characteristics that you like. There are many, actually.
Yeah.
So the selection criteria that you can now select in the filter, there are actually a lot of them. We call them focus criteria. You can click here, and you see here quite a few terms that we have used. Includes energy friendliness, which means energy efficiency, really, recycling, inclusive leadership as well, inclusive leadership. And even the one that is that I found quite interesting is trusted companies, countries.
Okay.
Companies that are headquartered in countries with high human rights, high business index, you know, ease of doing business index.
Yep.
We selected also companies that are in these markets, and maybe that's a good selection criteria to be safer as an investor.
It's a very interesting approach. It's good to be able to focus on, you know, oftentimes you would just select a market, but a geographical market, but not necessarily, you know, based on an intuitive feel of how good it is to do business there.
In addition, we also have exclusion criteria. There are people that don't want to invest in gambling or tobacco, alcohol. No, Muslims don't want to invest in alcohol. So we have also exclusion criteria. So you can filter out all the companies that have characteristics that you might not want.
Yep, that's great.
And now we're actually going a step further. Based on these criteria, we're starting to define focus markets.
Mm-hmm.
And this will actually lead to a cleanup of the selection criteria, because some of them are actually focus markets. And that means you can get top 10 stocks with those criteria.
Great.
Now, this is about to come. A few bug fixes as well that we have to do. We still have a trouble with a couple of companies that are not updated. I want to make sure all the stocks are updated all the time. But that's actually something that you can always find out yourself if you go to search. And if you pick a company like LafargeHolcim here, you see here this the research is actually from August 26. So you know if it's a recent research. And if here, you know, you have an old year, you know, this is an old rank. So it's possible to see that, but I want to make sure also the companies that have old ranks are updated more often.
Yeah.
By the way, also the financial reporting date here for Holcim is December 31st, 2020, because new data has not yet been entered into the system. These are things that we want to speed up now so that you get ranks faster.
Mm-hmm. And when you say data entered into the system, you mean data being entered into the supplier, your data supplier.
Yes, exactly. And then from them to us.
Yes.
Yeah, from them to us. Yeah, so a lot of new things, still working on some bug fixes, but I'm getting really excited about having a product that I find is quite useful now.
Yeah, looking forward to these focus markets and the top 10s.